All right. Good morning, cyber friend. It's the old Mini Man coming at you again from Walker's Music. Yet another word for the day. Matter of fact, it's a big word for the day, people. We give God all the praise. We give him all the glory for life, health, and strength, enabling us to do what we are supposed to do. And we come, as you see my title of my video said, Mini Man's Piano Anniversary. And I do mean that. It was 36 years ago today. In other words, it was at 4:30 in the afternoon on October 31st, 81. There you go. Yes, it was 1981, October 31st, people. 4:30 in the afternoon. It was, like you said, for those of you that celebrate and, you know, the Halloween trick-or-treat and stuff, yeah, well, you could say that. If you're more familiar with it, you don't want me to say October the 31st, then I speak what you say. Trick or treat. Halloween. It was on October 31st. I don't have no beef with that. But I just want to say that it has been a long haul. 36 years, people, don't seem as though it's a long time, but it is. It is. And matter of fact, at my first onset of the piano, when I first started with it, I was very, very diligent. I was very, very diligent because, like I said, I started a year before I actually entered school. In other words, I had studied the piano 1 year before I, almost 1 year, before I went and enrolled in the school of Andrew College. As a matter of fact, I enrolled in 82, the fall of 82, at Andrew. I graduated from there in 1984, and I spent 4 more years at Berry College in North Georgia, in the Rome, Georgia area. And I said in the Rome, Georgia area because Berry College is north of Rome, Georgia. It's called, really it's called Mount Berry, Georgia, but it's on the way on up into Chattanooga, Tennessee. That school, Berry, is at the foothills of the Appalachian. And I could go on and on telling you about Berry. This is not the reason why we came here for this here video. But it was to let you know that, yes, it was 36 years ago today that I started playing the piano. And I say I started taking up the piano as a student of the piano. And I tell you, I was straight crazy about my piano instructor. That actually came out professor, one of my professors, after I entered into Andrew College that next year. Because she was a professor there, and her husband that came to be her husband was the head of the music department, James Rhodes, and she became Constance Rhodes, but her maiden name I think was Constance Hunt, and we call her Connie, but I wished I knew what they were. Last I heard that they had was over at Shorter College, and this was during the time when I was at Berry, but I never did actually get a chance to go over that way to Shorter College to actually try to contact them and see what, try to catch up with them. And I hate to this very day that I ever not that I didn't do it, but I lost contact with them. But nevertheless, we give God the praise, and I just wanted to share that little bit with y'all, not to brag, but just to say, you know, as a minister of music, and I'm speaking now to, you know, to those of you that, all of us, you know, sometimes get wrong. Everybody can get wrong. That's what I'm telling you. You don't get too big in Christianity where you don't get wrong sometimes. See, because if you're not, if you could do that, then you wouldn't need Jesus. And the Lord is never going to let us rely totally on ourselves without needing him. And our weakness will be shown. Now, I'm not saying that you just got to keep drinking milk all the days of our life. No. Apostle Paul told us that one that they continue to drink milk is unskilled in the word. In other words, we should grow and be able to eat meat every now and then. But ever so often, some of us need that baby bottle and a diaper. I'm going to be honest with you, we all do. Sometimes we get self-pity and we get down on ourselves because people won't treat us the way we think we ought to be treated. And amen. Amen. And you know, you can't deal with it like that, but you must turn everything over into the hands of the Lord and be thankful for where God has brought you from. And that's what I want to just come to everybody today. It's, I'm sitting here this morning, early this morning, about 9. I've been up here since about, I guess about 6. But nevertheless, I'm just grateful and thankful, you know, to be still a part of the living. Yes, I'm still glad I'm walking and I'm talking. And I got a good portion of health and strength. We thanking God all the way. And like I said, being go back to the minister of music per se, you got to love your choir members. You got to love the people that you deal with, even though when they're not lovely. You hear what I say? Being a minister of music, and I'm talking to all you piano players especially, we have to love our choir members, even when they're not lovely. I'm going to say it again. We have to love our choir members, even though when they're not that lovely. Why do I say that? Because that's what's going to happen. You're going to always have one or two that's not going to obey. They're going to give you all the mess you want, because that's God's sandpaper that he's working out to make you more smoother. I found that out the hard way. But yes, you must love your choir members, even the ones that are not that lovely. So what we do, you know, you cannot, I always say this and I'm going to say it again, you can't help how people treat you. But God holds you responsible for how you treat them. So in other words, let us just run. I mean, I think back when I first started playing the piano. On that first day, that first piano lesson, 36 years ago today, that first lesson, I was all excited. I mean, you know, sitting on the bench with my piano instructor, and she was so nice and showing me everything. And matter of fact, I could show y'all my first piano book. I still have the book. It's not my original book, but I got one a little while ago. Excuse me, y'all, for taking me off the counter like that, but. You know what? I can't find it. It's back here somewhere, but I cannot find it. And I don't want to tear up all this stuff back here. But I think I've shown y'all the book. And it's the Older Piano Beginner Library. By Jane Basin. That was my first book. I was so excited, people. My great-grandmama was living. God bless her. Rest in peace. She was living. And when I got up there to that, in the music building, up there at Andrew College, and my piano instructor, I met her there. She was waiting on me. It was 4:30. Excuse me. I was on time. And it was just so, I mean, it was my first day on the first day that I began this journey, people, and I was excited. I didn't know what to expect. The only thing I knew, I wanted to take some piano lessons. And so, oh my God, she showed me certain things, and then she played certain things just for me to show me what would be the, she gave me a picture of the future. And I was wide open. I got every piece of sheet music I could find. I got some old sheet music back there 36 years ago. I think the one I bought was called Steel. One of Lionel Richard Commodore's songs, Steel and Lady. Well, that was Kenny Rogers, but Lionel Richard wrote it. Three Times a Lady. All them songs like that. I was able to play those songs, people, in my second year of piano lesson. That's how dedicated I was. But boy, by and by, I started slacking off. Especially after I graduated from Andrew and went to Berry. I had more higher learning at Berry, but I slacked off so much the way I used to diligently practice and rehearse my skill. That's my fault. But it was a very, very fun starting out, and I never have regretted it one bit. Even to now, like I say, I still play a little bit. I'm not, I mean, you know what I'm saying? I know I can't go back. You cannot regain your youth, people. Now, God can restore your youth. God can do that. But you can't go back. You can't live in the past. And I know for myself that right now what I've done in since I've been playing this piano 36 years ago today, I saw a lot of victories, but I've also had a few defeats. You know, my piano instructor at Berry, her name was Ms. Rowell, Faye. Her name, first name was Faye Rowell. And I hadn't heard from her in quite a while. But she told me that the one thing she always told me about the piano, she said, it is bigger than the both of us, Ernest. She said, you will always be learning the piano. She said, you're never going to grow up in it, so you're going to always be learning. So that's how come I say happy anniversary to me in the 36 years of piano playing, and we hope that we're going to get better as we go. We hope we can do more to enhance the music ministry at the churches that I am employed at right now. I got all kinds of ideas and things that I want to do, but sometimes it's hard to get people to do new things. But we're not going to stop trying. I just say it like that and leave it alone. This middle man telling you whatever you get into, if God ain't in it, it's best you get out of it, because it's going to come to nothing. So with this here 36th year anniversary of me playing the keyboard, we're going to say until the next Bible study, next video, whichever comes first. Peace. Good day.